32 Life Principles, Section 9. Sing a new song. Life Principle 31 is singing to glory. So life is a song and singing is life. So if you read Revelation, so the 144,000 people were singing a song which other people cannot sing. So that means life itself is a song. So Moses sang a beautiful song. Hannah sang song. Mary's song is so beautiful. And Sam's song, like Psalms 23, is marvelous. So life is a song and our experience becomes song that we sing unto the Lord. So Lord commanded us to sing new song. Our life should be full of new songs. So when we worship, when we come into the presence of Lord, we should coin new phrases, new ways of understanding God, experiencing God. For example, so the psalmist describes God in a different way. He is fortress, he is King of Kings, he is refuge, he is a hiding place. So he is a God who hears our prayer. So there are many names he gives. In the same way, we have to sing new song and singing to glory. So singing to glory means it is upward worship. Our lifestyle itself is worship. Worship is our lifestyle. So our consciousness is always pointed towards God. Our antenna is always trying to grasp or be in touch with God. So we should have the attitude of upward worship. So when we have the attitude of upward worship, inward cleansing happens. That is what happened in Isaiah chapter 6. So Isaiah was in the presence of God. He came to the presence of God, or he got the vision of God. So when Uzziah died. So until that time, his focus was Uzziah, who was on the throne in the city of Jerusalem. Now God showed him God himself seated on the throne in heaven. So his focus was changed. He could see God's angels singing, "Holy, holy, holy." So when he saw that, he had an inward cleansing. He understood he was a sinner. He needed the touch of God. And not only that, singing to glory means we should be surrounded by fellowship. In Psalms chapter 1, so if the blessed man does not sit among the mockers who mock God, who mock the promises of God, who mock the servants of God, but surrounded by the fellowship, the believers, the fellow saints. And also singing to glory means we march forward. Jehoshaphat organized the worship team to go into battlefield. So Jericho was captured by silent march. And on the seventh day, it was the rejoicing march, or the shout of worship, shout of giving honor to God. That helped them to move forward. So when we are singing to glory, it means it is upward worship, it is inward cleansing, surrounded by fellowship, and it is forward march. Our life is a song. Let us sing. God bless you.